Good morning, students of class 9. You are welcome back to the classes now. Let's continue our lesson in our democratic politics. We are coming to the end portion. So the chapter is what is democracy and why democracy. And we have reached the last portion, that is 2.4, broader meaning of democracy. So far we have learned about the different features of democracy and the type of democracy. So here there are altogether 7 points I've written over here. You go through it properly, listen carefully, and we'll try to understand each one. Now here, the most common form of democracy all over the world, many of the countries they have changed into democratic countries. So after their independence, they were formed into a democratic country such as India. So the most common form of democracy is the representative form of democracy. Representative democracy. That means we elect the representative and they will rule the country for the people. So now, but it does not allow this. Just by looking at democracy, and we have learned about all the features and all the qualities of a democracy, but by just looking at those features, it does not allow us to distinguish between a democracy and a good democracy. So we have learned about democracy, but what is the meaning of good democracy? That we don't know exactly so far. So, but it does not allow, so far whatever we have learned about democracy, its features, its qualities, it does not allow us to distinguish or make a difference between a democracy and a good democracy. Now here today we'll learn about a good democracy. Now here, for this, we need to turn to broader meaning of democracy. To understand a good democracy, we have to learn its meaning. So what is the meaning of a good democracy, or broader meaning of democracy? The ideal standard, the good standard that all good democracy must aim to become one of, the good democracy. So the democracy all over the world, or you can say the democratic countries all over the world, they must try to become a good democracy, a good democratic country. And for that reason, what they have to do? They must try always to become one of the best democracies. So true democracy will come. No doubt, many of the countries around the world, they are democratic countries. But a true democracy will come to this country, or to our country, or to the other countries around the world, only when no one goes hungry to bed, when all will have sufficient food, they can sleep with their full stomach. If a person or a citizen goes to bed without food, or go to bed hungry, that means it is not a pure democratic country. That means the democracy has not helped that person. So no one, that means only when no one goes to hungry to bed. One feature, the broader meaning of democracy. Number two, in a democracy, every citizen must be able to play equal role in decision making. Many of the countries, many people are not allowed to participate in the decision making. So in a democracy, in a good democracy, all the people must be able to play equal role in decision making, and needs to have equal information. All must have equal information, basic education, equal resources, and a lot of commitment in a democracy. But by looking at these ideals, many of the country doesn't follow these things. They were democracies only in the namesake. But if we take these ideals seriously, if you look at these ideals seriously, then no country in the world is democratic. No country in the world is a real democracy, because sort of lot of things are lacking there. So yet still these ideals remind us, these ideals will remind us of why we value democracy and identify its weakness, where we are lagging behind. By looking at these ideals and going through these ideals to become a good democracy, we find lot of weaknesses, shortcomings And once we identify, once a democracy or a democratic government identifies its weakness, where they are lagging behind, then the plan and schemes are made. The plans and schemes are made to end the human suffering so that the democracy will move forward to become a good democracy. So, schemes and plans are made to end the suffering, and this will help to become a good democracy. So these weaknesses, once they are solved, it's very difficult to solve. It's not easy. You cannot solve it within a year or two. It will take time. But the schemes are made, plans are made to end the human sufferings. So that the democracy will move forward to become a good democracy. These are the ideals that a democracy must fulfill, especially only when no one goes to hungry to bed. So many millions of people are poor. Many of them go to bed without having food. Hardly they will have one or two square meals of food in a day. So the democracy, the effort of the democratic government is to fulfill their basic needs so that the government will become a good democratic government. So now we can see that this is the broader meaning of democracy. So now we have learned 7 points, and that is the end of the chapter. Now we'll have to go through another one. So that's all for today. Thank you for your attention and your presence. You go through it properly.